Bang, bang!
We plunge to the bottom of the seas and take to the skies in search of the perfect inventions.
I can't believe it's working!
Faster than a speeding bullet. Heavier than a death metal band. And more bonkers than your maddest physics teacher. On today's Whiz Whiz Bang Bang, Jordan will be trying to build his ultimate marine machine to meet the ultimate marine predator. Meet Jordan. He's from Hartlepool. Jordan hates dirty dishwater and scrubbing those plates clean. Don't we all? The kind of water Jordan really loves is the sea. A bit of coastline and a few miles in front of him, and he's a happy guy. Jordan, welcome to the Whiz Whiz Bang Bang Workshop.
Oh, it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, it's jam-packed full of stuff. Now, your invention, it's all about water, right?
Yeah, it's called the Bubble Bug Pod, and it goes underwater, and you can, like, run about in it, and you can see, like, all the sea life and
wow,
underwater.
So it's like a big ball, and you can travel around in it.
Yeah.
The great thing is, you don't get wet. Now, what would be the best thing to see when you're underwater?
Oh, probably have to be the sharks.
Right, so, Jordan, I think there's something that you need to consider for your invention.
Yep.
How do you want to get underwater?
I want to go underwater in a bubble.
In a bubble, right? So if we take a big bubble of air, right?
It floats.
Uh-huh.
But that's why I want to put weight on it.
OK, go on then, press it down. You be the weight. Go on. What's it like?
It's really hard to get under the water.
That's because you're having to displace all that water around the side of the balloon. Imagine that big enough to fit you inside. Imagine the amount of weight you're going to need to put on that to get it under.
It'd take ages to get down.
And how much weight would it need?
Tons of weight.
How on earth is that ever going to come back up to surface?
It's going to take ages.
Viable idea? So, how about building just the classic submarine, you know? Get you in that, zooming along. Jordan in a submarine.
I suppose so, yeah, but it's already been invented.
OK.
And I'm going for something new.
True. This is supposed to be an invention show. Right. That's gone then. So, think of something new then. Let's get brainstorming. OK. Well, how about trying to get a bit of inspiration from something else?
Well, I suppose we could base it on a duck. It can go on top water when it wants to, and it can go underwater when it needs.
Brilliant. Is there no end to Jordan's creative thinking? I love the idea of having an invention that can both float and dive. But by ditching his first idea, has Jordan thought about the fact that the bubble bod pod gave him the ability to breathe underwater? More about that later. So, if we're not going with the bubble bod pod idea, what are we going to use for your invention, Jordan?
Why don't we use this canoe to go underwater in?
It's a good plan. It's a good plan. All right, then. But this is good for floating, Jordan. How are we going to get underwater?
Well, you could drill a few holes in it.
Go on, then. Here we go. Push nice and hard. Good lad. Yes, and out. Yes. Now, Jordan, not much water's going to get in there, is it?
No, it's
no.
Not.
No. What do you want?
I want bigger. Yeah.
Got it.
It's the first
one. Oh, no, that's what I call a hole.
That will definitely let in a lot of water.
Greg, you know when we don't want to go underwater and we've got big holes, how are we meant to stop going underwater?
How about just a little plug from the bath? Stretch it, stick it in.
Well, I think that might be just a little too small.
All right, it's only messing with you. How about this?
Well, what's that called?
This is called a butterfly valve. Try it, squeeze that and pull it towards you. There you go. So that's the valve there. We can stick that in. So when you want to stay on the surface, you can shut it and the water won't go through.
Oh, cool.
When you want to start to sink, open it up.
Oh, yeah.
Perfect?
Yeah.
Will that do you?
Yeah.
OK, so, Jordan, we have a canoe and we have holes in it. This is my scale model of your canoe with you inside. Lovely. Right, now if we sink this, watch what happens to you inside. Ready?
Oh no.
Not good, right?
No.
That's you hurtling towards the floor like that. Now, what do boats normally have to keep them more stable?
Boats tend to have a keel.
Mm-hmm. A keel, exactly, right. So you attach the keel to the bottom. What the keel does is adds weight below its normal centre of mass, right? So it gives it a lot more weight at the bottom, makes it a lot more stable. Let's see what happens. There it goes. Much better.
Yep.
Much, much better. Still a little bit unstable.
Yep.
Right, now, there is a cunning plan that you can do to this. If you pick that one up and attach that to the top, right, this is just a big bit of foam that we have waterproof there. So it's like having a big container of air. Okay? Now it's just like a fisherman's float. You have weight at the bottom, air at the top, and it keeps the string vertical.
Okay.
Okay, so hopefully this should give you an awful lot more stability. Watch what happens. There we go. And should float.
There we go.
There you go, look, it's just bobbing nice and happy. Now if you wobble the top of it with your finger, watch what happens. It self-rights itself.
Cool.
So it's really nice and stable. So that's the one I think that we should go for on your canoe.
Yep.
So, you take that to Ralph and say, Ralph, I'd like one a lot bigger.
There are lots of problems with using a canoe. By drilling holes in it, we can overcome the fact that canoes are designed to float. But the biggest problem with his canoe idea is how are we going to breathe underwater? The great thing about Jordan's initial invention was that it wasn't just a way of watching sea life, it also acted as a life support machine. So I've arranged for us to get some dive training. If we're going to make Jordan's invention idea a reality, we need to learn how to breathe underwater. And while we're there, he might just learn a bit more about how he can make his invention go up and down.
Try breathing from the regulator. Sit. Nice and deeply and slowly. Sit.
It's very cold on my teeth, it's kind of tingly.
Yes, it is quite cold, isn't it? Beautiful. Okay, shall we get in the water and go diving?
Let's do it.
Put it in your mouth, and you're just gonna put your face in the water and see what it feels like to breathe underwater. Okay?
You know, this is gonna be a weird experience. Good question, that, mate. The reason is that if you take a mouthful of air when you're at the surface and dive down, the pressure increases as you dive down because of all the water around you, right? So you take the amount of air you breathe in at the surface and dive right down, it's going to squish like that. Right, I've got a great experiment, but I need a bottle. Come on. Bottle, the air inside is just like the air in your lungs. And this is what happens when you go underwater.
Okay guys, so take your low pressure inflator, the buoyancy control here. Now the button on the left, that puts the air in the jacket.
That one?
Yeah, helps you float. Button on the top lets the air out and helps you sink.
quite a good way of moving up and down in the water.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? What, if I press one button and
go up and
it's another button and sink?
Really good.
Started thinking about his invention already, isn't he?
Excellent.
Right, so we know how to make this thing sink.
Yeah.
How are we going to make it float?
Well, you know, like in scuba diving where we had the tanks?
Yep.
How about we fill some big, huge tanks with air, the compressed air?
So exactly the same as the scuba?
Yeah, just but check just with a little bit bigger.
Shh. Yep, compressed gas, yep. So we can play with the buoyancy level again, yep. Just like on the scuba diving.
Just to make sure we do float.
Yeah, Ralph, we need some big tanks.
Ooh.
Yes, Ralph. When we said big tanks...
Big.
The size of that?
Four, I think that might do.
Absolutely, that is one massive air tank. So we'll squirt some of that in there so we can play with that buoyancy level. Keep going.
Tight, one butterfly valve. Here we go. Watch this. Whoosh.
Man. Right, so let's go and have a look at this buoyancy tube then. Right, so we've got a hollow tube.
Yeah.
We're going to stick this right on the end of it. That is where the air is going to be injected in from our cylinder tank, just like our scuba tank. And we're going to connect it with these. This seal here is going to provide an airtight and watertight seal. So the water can't get in and the air can't get out.
Yeah.
Alrighty?
Okay.
Go on then, Ralph. Pop that on there. Oh,
go. No. Here we are. Go. Whoa, lovely.
Yeah. Yeah, we're there.
Wigs at the ready. Get steady, bonkers science. This one's tasty, but don't try it home.
Now, Katrina from Shetland writes in and she goes, "Ooh, yuck. I don't like red cabbage and my mum keeps trying to feed me with it. Is there anything I can do, Greg, to make it less..." Well, Katrina, yes, there is. Loads of stuff you can do in the kitchen. Lots and lots of chemistry. All I've done is sliced up some red cabbage and I've put it in a container like this. Put on some slightly warm water and just let it stew. Oh, see why you don't like it? It stinks. Anyway, here it is. Lovely purple liquid. That is going to act as a pH indicator. That basically means it'll be able to tell you whether something is acid or alkali. Let me show you. If I take some lemon juice, which is citric acid, lob that in. Ta-da! See the colour change? Went from purple to red. That's because it went from neutral, which was purple, to show us that there was an acid present. Lemon juice, it's because it makes you go when you're eating it, it's because it's an acid. Ugh. The way to make it go back again to purple is to add some alkali, sodium bicarbonate of soda. You ready? Lob it in, stand back. Lovely, beautiful. Give it a stir. Can you see the colour? It's gone so far, it's actually gone blue because it's an alkali. It's gone from red right through purple to blue. So there you go, Katrina. Hope that answers your question. Loads of fun chemistry you can do in your kitchen. Bonkers science.
Before we went bonkers, Jordan had worked out that his underwater bubble idea was not going to work because a sphere full of air would float. He hit upon the idea of redesigning a canoe to help him achieve his dream of seeing underwater marine life. In his first design, Jordan was going to be able to walk on the seabed, but his redesign means that he's going to need another way of powering his invention. I think we should take inspiration from his favourite marine creature, the shark.
And the world-famous RoboShark.
Wow, cool. Why did you build this, Andrew?
Well, we were trying to spy on sharks to see if they were really clever or not, and also to carry a camera and sneak in and get secret behaviour.
What did the real sharks make of him?
Well, the small sharks just came in and bumped him, but the great whites actually came in and bit his forehead.
How does it work, though?
Well, as you can see here with RoboShark 2, we've put two engines in his head and it sucks the water through the mouth and
sucks
out of his
gill. Sucks it through here and spits it out here. Oh,
yeah, exactly. He just changed the speed of the engines and it goes left and right.
Oh, my God.
Oh, to make it dive?
To make him dive, we've actually got these chambers, one in the nose and one in the tail.
So it's just like the ballast tanks on your invention, right? One you fill with water, makes it really heavy and it sinks. Or you fill it with air, it makes it really light and it floats. So RoboShark uses ballast tanks to go up and down, just like Jordan's underwater canoe. We now need to solve the problem of how to power Jordan's invention through the water. We can't use engines like the RoboShark because they're protected within RoboShark's body. So let's find out how Jordan is planning on powering his underwater canoe. So that's the going up and down. Yeah. What about the forwards and backs? What about power? What should we use?
I was thinking kind of a big propeller.
Yeah? Nice big propeller. This is going to be an absolute monstrous invention. Everything is just...
How about that?
Well, the thing is, though, we need to actually move.
Honestly, sometimes he gets it, sometimes he doesn't get it. That's more like...
Try this,
oh,
baby.
That'll do.
Yeah, so this is a dive scooter. This is what scuba divers usually hold to pull them through the water.
Oh, cool.
So we could mount that on the boat. Where do you want it?
To somewhere near the back.
OK, push you along.
Yeah.
Great. But do you really think that is going to be big enough to move this monstrosity?
Oh, hopefully, yeah.
Yeah, I hope so.
On the corner. Pop this on.
What's that?
This is a big welding magnet. Look, you can just stick anything to it like that. So it'll just hold those in place while Ralph does his welding.
Cool.
Okay, masks down. Remember, you can't look at this with the naked eye.
Ready? Stand by. There you are, Greg. All done.
Safe?
Yep, safe.
Right, let's get this thing all bolted piece by piece. Goes on this one here.
This one?
That's it, perfect. Right, we need to get these tanks on the side. Could do with a hand, though, I think, lads. Randy, come, Jordan. That's it.
Are we in?
Excellent. Yes. Right, now these, okay, yes. These are going to be right where we're sat. So these are what we're going to be pulling, and they open the valves at the front and the back. That one is the front one, that one is the back one. They open the valves and let air out or into these. What that's going to do is change your angle in the water. So as you're sinking, you can keep yourself nice and stable and horizontal.
Oh, cool.
Great bit of design work, that.
Yep.
Right, guys, I think I need to let you lot do the final few tweaks. Ralph, you know what it's time for?
It's time a professional in a wig did some bonkers science, but you really should not try this at home.
Now, Katie from Newport texted in and she said, my mum says that money must burn a hole in my pocket. Do you know what she means? Well, no, Katie, but I can show you something pretty cool with money and burning. If I take a bit of paper, dip it in some water and try to burn it...
Don't try this at home.
Nothing really happens, because all you're doing is just boiling off the water. If I take a second bit of paper, and this time I'm going to dip it in 100% flammable liquid. Watch. Now that's burning. Only problem is, it burns the bit of paper too. This time I'm going to mix the two together. Watch. Like that, and
Add a bit of salt as well, just in the mixture there. Give it a bit of a stir. Now, I need my bit of paper to dip in. That one's useless. Haven't got... Anyone got any paper? Or a fiver? What's a fiver? Yes. Yeah, lovely. All right, you must trust me. So, one £5 note dipped in my concoction there. Time to burn it, I think. You ready? It's burning. It's burning. Don't panic. There's your fiver. Not harmed. So it burns. That's just the water boiling off. So that is how money can burn a hole in your pocket, or how you can just take the fiver home at the end of the day. Now that's bonkers science for you.
If you've got an invention you just can't wait to send in, then draw us a picture and send it to PO Box 16846, Glasgow G11 9BL. Or text WWBB and your invention idea to 62222. Charged to operators' standard text rates, please ask permission. Jordan came to us with an invention that would allow him to get close to his favourite marine life creatures. The problem with using a bubble for his invention was that it is full of air and it would take a lot of weight to make it sink. He decided that he could use the basics of a canoe and modify it by drilling holes in the hull. To keep it afloat, he would need huge flotation tanks on either side of the boat. The problems didn't stop there. By putting such huge tanks on the side of his canoe, Jordan had made his invention very unstable. To get around this, Jordan designed two ballast tanks which would act as stabilizers. In theory, the two tanks above the boat would act as two underwater balloons which would make the canoe float like a hot air balloon. As this is the first time an invention like this has been tested, we decided it might be best to take it to the home of underwater filming.
Pinewood Studios!
Whoa, isn't that the place where they make all them big feature films?
Absolutely. Yes, it is.
Cool.
Oh, Jordan, look. They are just putting the finishing touches to the underwater stage for your test. You know who's been in here?
Go on then, who?
Daniel Craig, James Bond.
What?
Angelina Jolie, Lara Croft.
Class.
Doctor Who.
I never would have guessed that.
And next, Jordan.
Oh, cool.
How you feeling?
Well, I'm pretty cool, but it looks a bit deep and dark down there, but yeah.
There could be anything down there.
Nervous, Greg?
Me? Never. Let's test this thing.
Cool, yeah.
Okay, you're happy? I'm going to get in as well. And because you are driving, yes, I just want to make sure you know what all those controls do. So talk me through it.
Okay, well, first there's the motor, and to accelerate, push that forwards. Then the two big red buttons put air into the top two canisters. The two ropes here, they let the air out. And these two big side tanks here, you put air into them by pulling this back, and you put... Yeah, let the air out by lifting these backwards. But before we do all that, we've got to pull the butterfly valves backwards and let all the water gush in.
If Jordan hasn't got his sums right and we put too little air in the flotation tanks, the canoe will sink to the bottom with him in it. Too much air and he'll just bob along the top like a duck. And even if we do get his invention underwater, we have no idea of knowing whether the ballast tanks will keep it stable enough to drive.
Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, masks on.
This is a big moment for Jordan. Will his invention sink to the bottom, or will his ingenious idea of using flotation and ballast tanks succeed?
Brilliant! Everything seems to be working fine. All the controls are behaving themselves and the engine is propelling us along nicely. Now we know that his invention works, I think it's time to have some fun with all this movie technology. Jordan, you wanted to see marine life. Well, here it comes. Jordan has designed and built an underwater canoe. Time to surface and find out if we've made his dreams come true.
Whoa! Oh! Oh! What do you think, mate?
It's just totally brilliant.
Oh, what was that like when it was coming?
It was really scary at the beginning because we were like going down it, like so far an angle over to one side.
Yeah.
But then once we got to the bottom, it just settled out and we were like really calm and seeing the invention turn from a piece of paper, it's something in real life.
What a wicked, awesome invention, nice one. We'll see you next time on Whiz Whiz Bang Bang.